Hi, in this video, I'm going to take you through a complex lookup function where a lookup value is caught in between a larger text. So what I need to do here is that I need to identify the country of each of these stock exchange based on the city in which they are. I already have a table with me which shows me which city is in which country. But the problem is the city here is not available to me in a separate column. And there is no pattern in this text, as you can see, through which I can extract the city into a separate column either. So how do we handle it? I'm going to show the solution in two steps so that it's relatively easy for you to follow. So first, what I'm going to do is I am going to identify the row number of the city. And to do this, I'm going to use a match function. Match for what? A false. So here I am indicating that I don't want a condition to be satisfied. Which condition should not be satisfied is that when I try to find the cities in this list, it should not be an error. That's what I'm going to do. And the way to give that is match for false iserr find all these cities in the text that I have here. Let me first finish the formula and then I'll explain you how it works. So I'm going to close this bracket once more. So firstly, I close the ifFind function. Now I'm closing the isErr function. I'm going to now close the match function, but the match should be for exact match. So let me specify that comma zero and let me close it. So now if you look at it, formula has found that Tokyo is in the second row of my city table. Now that I know that the city is in the second row, I can get the country easily using the index function. So I'm going to say index of the countries. And from this country array, pull out the data that's in the second row and close the bracket. Enter, I've got the answer. Let's quickly understand how this function works. So what the find function does is, so it's going to find for all the cities in the list here. So when I press F9, what it notices is, you know, Mumbai is not found in this text, so it gives me a value error. Tokyo is found in the sixth place, so it's not giving me an error, it's just giving me a six. So similarly for all other cities here, they are not found in B4, so we got a value error. Now the isError function is going to now evaluate whether these outputs that we got here are error. If it's error, it'll return true. If it's not error, it's going to return false. So let me press F9. So you notice that only in the case where it was not error, which means the city was found, it gives you a false as the answer. Everywhere else, it's giving you answer as true. And we are using the match function to find out where the false comes in this array. And false is the second value here. So match function returns me answer as 2. And that's how this formula worked. Now, we use a complex array operation here. And these complex array operations work very well in Office 365. If you're using prior versions of Office or if you're using OpenOffice, then you have to do one slight tweak. So let me quickly show that to you with my OpenOffice. So in OpenOffice, when I tried the same formula, it's giving me error here. The reason is OpenOffice was not good at handling arrays. There is one exception, however. The sum product function could handle arrays very well in all the spreadsheets. So if you're using any of the older versions, what we need to do is we need to wrap up this function inside a sum product function. And that's what I'm going to do now. So I'll wrap all this formula inside a sum product function and that's going to work for me. Hope you found the video useful. If you have a different way of handling this problem, share that in the comment section and see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.